dealing with light near dissociation. Now that you understood the basic anatomy of the pupillary reflex pathway, so light near dissociation. Now, what is this light and what is this near and the dissociation that we are talking about? So you already know about the light reflex, right? So you already know about the light reflex. So now what you need to know is about the near reflex. What is the other name for this near reflex? The accommodation reflex, right? The accommodation triad. Accommodation reflex. You remember the accommodation triad, the second component I always keep telling you. So the first component is convergence of the eyeballs when you look at a near object. The second component is meiosis. And the third component is increase in anterior curvature of the lens. So the second component, the meiosis, is achieved by this accommodation reflex, right? So light reflex also leads to meiosis. Near reflex also leads to meiosis. But now there is a dissociation. So now the pupil is not reacting to light, but it is reacting to near, alright? So that is what is light near dissociation. So there's like some dissociation. I react very differently to somebody telling me something and I say probably I want to ignore somebody, so when somebody that person is talking to me, I don't react at all. Okay, I actually ignore that person. But when a friend is talking to me, I react. Okay, I respond. So it's something like that. I'm a dissociative personality like that. So there is a light near dissociation. Okay, so it's always please remember, there is no condition where the near reflex will be absent. Is that clear? And will be absent and light reflex will be present. That's just not possible. If near reflex is absent, then definitely light reflex will also be absent. Aise nahi ho sakta hai jisme aapko near reflex absent hai aur light reflex present hai. If the other way is possible, that is light reflex absent and near reflex is present. Now this is what is light near dissociation. Now, the first and foremost thing I want you to understand is light near dissociation is not just, or it's not equivalent to Argyll Robertson pupil. Hota hai Argyll Robertson pupil, alright? It happens in Argyll Robertson pupil, but that just simply does not mean that light near dissociation ka matlab hai Argyll Robertson pupil. So there are very many conditions where this dissociation can occur. Is that clear? So keep that in mind. Now let's see why this light near dissociation occurs first of all. Now what are these fibers? Actually they are all pupillary fibers, but thoda sa difference hai. Kya difference hai? Where these pupillary fibers are present? Now let me draw this for you. I know many of you might look at me, you know, very very wearily, ma'am, kya kar rahe ho? Do you remember this? Do you remember this? Ma'am, you're complicating stuff all the way. Okay. Now, this is the cut section of the midbrain. At what level are we talking about? This is the superior colliculi. Okay, the superior colliculi. I always tell you, don't get worried about these big names. Colliculus means bump. Okay. So, when you look at this brain stem, so there are bumps on the dorsal side. So, we look at the brain from the dorsal side. This is your dorsal side, right? So, we look at the brain stem from the dorsal side. You see four bumps. So, you have the two superior bumps, the superior colliculi, and the two inferior bumps, the inferior colliculi. I know people love English. It's just simple. Ophthalmology is so damn simple. So, colliculus is that bump. Now, what is the superior colliculi? That is where your third nucleus is. So at this level, the third nucleus is located. But where is this third nucleus located? It's here. Okay, it's here at this level. Now, what is this central thing that I've drawn? This is the cerebral aqueduct. You remember the cerebral aqueduct? And around this, we have a periductal gray matter. Okay, perineum around the duct. Which duct? We're talking about the cerebral aqueduct, and you have a gray matter there. And you have this third nucleus. Here, okay, so this is the third nucleus, oculomotor nucleus. All right, so now this is dorsal, this is ventral. Okay, this is dorsal and this is ventral. Now, where do you think the third nerve will exit? Will it exit on this side or this side? On this side, because we know the only cranial nerve that exits on the dorsal side is your fourth cranial nerve, that is your trochlear nerve. So this has to exit on the ventral side. Alright. So you have the fibers which are going to pass like this and come out. Isn't it simple? There's nothing big that you have to memorize in this. Just put two and two together and use a little bit of your common sense. Alright. And for common sense, you need to sleep adequately. That's what I can tell you. Sleep adequately, not less. Now, third nucleus is here. Now I told you the third nucleus has very many subnuclei. Now, where is this parasympathetic subnucleus? Now, the parasympathetic subnucleus, so now this is a huge nucleus, okay? Actually, this is a huge nucleus. Now, this parasympathetic subnucleus is here, okay? It's here. So, now when the fibers, so now we have pupillary fibers. Now, pupillary fibers, what are the two types of pupillary fibers we have? I have the light fibers and I have the near fibers. Okay, at the near. But where is the center for my light reflex? It is the pretectal nucleus. Okay, so the pretectal nucleus is somewhere a little more on the dorsal side. Okay, so this acts for the light reflex. The center is pretectal nucleus. Now they say for the near fibers, there's a little different center which they have not really localized. If they start looking bad, they have not really looked like. There's a lot of controversy about this. Let's not go into that. So the light reflex ka center is at the pretectal nucleus, which is more dorsally located. And we know what are the internuncial neurons are running from here to the Edinger-Westphal nucleus. Now let's say I have a dorsal midbrain syndrome. Now what is this dorsal midbrain syndrome? Ab dekho, agar yahan pe there is a pineal body also there in that area, and if the child has a hydrocephalus, what will happen in hydrocephalus? Now this area, there is going to be too much of pressure, and there is going to be around this area, there is going to be some mass effect. Alright, so which is going to be affected? Your pretectal nucleus. And pretectal nucleus is the center for light reflex. So light reflex, it's gone, it's absent. Alright, but near fibers are supposed to be more ventrally located. So they come from somewhere, but they are more ventrally located. Okay, so they are more ventrally located. So obviously they will be spread. Yes, now imagine I'm in a bus. Okay, I'm in a bus and say it's a 3-seater bus. Now imagine on the window side there is one real fat lady, or let's say there is one on the window side there is one real fat lady sitting. Now who is it going to affect? The one who is sitting adjacent to the fat lady much more. Okay, she's going dhakka maar rahi hai, dhakka maar rahi hai. So usi ko problem hoga na, jo third person idhar hai is taraf, fir bhi he has some space this side where he can shift and somehow he can manage. So just same way, alright. So these light fibers are located more dorsally. That is why there is a dorsal midbrain syndrome where you have light reflex absent, whereas near reflex is present. Now this is light near dissociation. So I have still not talked about Argyll Robertson pupil. So what is the example I've given you? The example that I have given you is dorsal midbrain syndrome, which goes by this beautiful name, Paranoid's dorsal midbrain syndrome. Okay, so in Paranoid's dorsal midbrain syndrome also you're going to have what? You're going to have light near dissociation. Right, now in Argyll Robertson pupil, okay, now coming to your AR pupil, AR pupil also there is some irritation of these fibers. Okay, neuros classically described. So let's move on to Argyll Robertson pupil. I hope you have understood this. I'll come back to this later. I hope you got a basic idea of what I'm talking about. So we'll come back to this picture a little later when we need it again for third week. Okay. So now I'm moving on to Argyll Robertson pupil. ARP. Now what is this ARP? All of you know that accommodation reflexes present. Ab to aapko pata hi hai. So what is absent? The light reflex is absent. ARP, accommodation reflex, also called as near reflex, is present. Okay. So now suppose there is an option which says near reflex present. Don't get confused. Arey, maine to ARP padha tha. Yahan pe kya diya hua hai? Dono are same names. Just like you are called some kittu, something at home, some nickname for you, Nikki, Kiki, whatever. So accommodation reflex has another name, near reflex. So near reflex will be present. Light reflex is absent. Okay, so light reflex is absent. So which is ultimately what is it? It is a light near dissociation. A present there, a absent there. All right. Now, what about the classical cause? Now, the classical cause. Somebody describe. Who is that somebody? This handsome man called Argyll Robertson. Once upon a time. So he described, classically described this in Tabes dorsalis. Now what is Tabes dorsalis? Tabes dorsalis is your neurosyphilis. So he was in those years, okay, in the 1800s, he lived in the 1800s when they did not have enough antibiotics against the syphilis organism. So it, syphilis was quite common. Nowadays you don't get to see syphilis at all. So in those days, they saw so much of neurosyphilis, and this classically caused this kind, this picture of Argyll Robertson pupil. So this is the classical cause. Now, coming to present day, syphilis hi nahi hota hai, toh neurosyphilis ki baat toh dur hai, it doesn't happen only. So now what is the most common cause? The most common cause of Argyll Robertson pupil nowadays is diabetes. Okay, so nowadays the most common cause is Argyll Robertson pupil is diabetes. Okay, so this is Argyll Robertson pupil, and here the pupils are myotic. Is that clear? So this is another MCQ for you. How is the pupil in Argyll Robertson pupil? It is a myotic pupil. I hope I made myself clear about Argyll Robertson pupil. So we will move to the other pupils in a subsequent video. All right.